Hello guys, and welcome to another amazing tutorial. And this is gonna be one of the money tutorials, how I'm gonna call it. In this tutorial, I've been promising to show you something amazing for a couple weeks now. I always talk about, you know, more. And in the past couple tutorials, I sort of been repeating myself, I guess, with the color grading, just pretty much doing the same thing over and over. And in this tutorial, I want to show you how you can use DaVinci Resolve, whether it's a full version, studio version, or light version, how you can use DaVinci Resolve to remove object from the scene. Now, before you're going to start saying, you know, it's not After Effects, it's not Nuke or whatever, obviously it's not any of that kind of software, you know, it's not really designed for this kind of work. But on the basic level, on a very basic level, let's say you have shot something like this. Like in this shot, I have this hole right over here. And it's, I don't know, it's kind of sticks out, you know, and it looks really awkward. And I'm going to show you right now how you actually can remove this and fix your shot. Okay, so watch me. You're going to love it. It's going to be absolutely amazing. I guarantee you probably more than 90% of people, and I'm talking about advanced people who use DaVinci Resolve, have no idea about this function or how to use it, okay? So for you guys, I want to show you, and I want you guys to know the secret, okay? So here's our shot. Obviously, like I said before, I'm not going to be bothering doing any kind of color grading work, so I'm just going to slap black magic cloth over here, that way our shot looks semi-decent. Okay, as you can see, a couple things. First of all, my hand's shaking over here. I shot this handheld on black magic pocket camera, and as some of you guys know, it's very uncomfortable camera to hold. I mean, even if you have a handle on top, I had Sigma 18-35 lens on it, and I mean, I don't know, the whole thing just shakes like crazy, so you definitely need a rig for it. But anyways, you know, I got this shot, and let's work with what we got, okay? So I'm just gonna lower it a little bit just to protect the highlights. And I'm gonna create a next note, a new note, and I'm gonna right click and call it remove. Okay, so pay attention, this is gonna be awesome right now. I'm gonna zoom in over here on our little hole or whatever this thing is, and I'm gonna go and select, I can select the circle right here, but I'm gonna select the costume custom curve. And what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna select all the area around it. Okay, that looks pretty good. Let's see, that looks sweet. Okay, that's good enough. And the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna track this down. So let me go to the frame one, let me place this thing properly, and my camera is not zooming. I also don't have any perspective, so there's no reason wasting resources tracking this down. So I'm gonna uncheck all this and let's track forward. Okay, and as we see, Resolve actually does have pretty good tracker. The whole thing looks like it sticks really, really good. We sort of see a little bit of movement. Actually, I probably should uncheck rotate and track it again and see if it's gonna stick a little bit better. Okay, let's check it out. All right, way better. Always remember, just because you have everything checked, that doesn't mean you're gonna get a better result when you tracking the material. So we have this thing tracked. What's next? Well, that's the very first step. Next thing, let me zoom out a little bit so you can see. The very important thing is you have to offset this thing before you're gonna go in that window. So as we have our tracking information, I'm just gonna move this thing right over here, okay? So we're gonna move it right here, and we're gonna see that now the tracking window is just empty by itself, hanging in the air. Okay, so now let's go over here, let's select node sizing, You know what I'm gonna do? Watch this. Watch the magic. I'm gonna move this thing over here. Right over here. Okay. That looks really good. I'm gonna go back to the mask, which is this one. And I'm just gonna feather it a little bit. Okay. Like that. Outside. Perfect. Okay. Let me create a new node so you can see. Boom. Just like that. For example, if that is a client that have no idea that there's a hole in there, they will never be able to tell. Even though, obviously, for the lesson, it kind of looked a little bit strange because we know it, we've seen how it looks before, you know. But if somebody doesn't know, this thing is completely gone. Look, and it's sticking to the handle. Everything is absolutely legit. Okay, let's try to do one more. Let's try to do, I don't know, let's find some spot in here. Let's try to do, I guess, with this reflection, if it's gonna allow me to track it. Okay, so I'm just gonna repeat the step so you guys can learn it a little bit better. Okay, I'm just gonna select this. Okay, just like that. I'm gonna go to the tracker. I'm gonna uncheck all this. I'm gonna track it back, and I'm gonna track it front. I don't think it's gonna be really good track, but let's see, it may work. And again, I'm gonna offset it right over here. I'm gonna go to the node sizing, and I'm just gonna move it right over here, and then right over here. Then I'm gonna go back to the mask, and I'm just gonna feather it a little bit. Look at that, it's gone. Like never existed before. Okay? This kind of technique ideally works on the shots that you don't have parallax, because once you have parallax, it's very difficult. I don't think DaVinci Resolve Tracker is that great for the parallax movement, but for more or less camera like this, or for the still shots, you can easily remove any kind of objects you like. All right, so now you guys know how to remove things from your shots, and please subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be showing more cool stuff that a lot of people don't know, and see you next time. Thanks.